Good evening, sisters of the City of Angels International Christian Church. As many of you know, our annual Women's Day entitled Precious Love is just around the corner. And I know many of you have been working tirelessly, smoothing out all the details. For some of you, this may be your first Women's Day in person. And so today I just want to empower you with some etiquette and some tips on how to make this Women's Day the best one yet. So let's get started. Practical number one is be prepared. And something I want to encourage all of the sisters to do is prepare all of your things the night before. This means taking a shower, getting your hair done, making sure everything is in your bag that you need so that in the morning you have your quiet time, you're calm, and everything is set to go. And so here are some do's and don'ts. Practical number two is fill your cup. And by this, I mean have an incredible time with God the morning of Women's Day. It's so important that as sisters, we fill ourselves spiritually so that during Women's Day, we're able to give back to our guests. And so here are some do's and don'ts. Practical number three is be early. Sisters, we do not want to show up late to our own Women's Day, especially with no visitor and with a Starbucks coffee. We want to show up early so that we can help serve and fellowship with the visitors that are coming in. So here are some do's and don'ts. Practical number four is presence. What we wear, sisters, truly speaks volumes. It shows that we respect God and that we care about the visitors coming into Women's Day. And so we do not want to come in looking like a hot mess. So here are some do's and don'ts.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Practical number five is have a great attitude. With Women's Day, especially the morning of, a lot of feelings can come up. Maybe your visitor doesn't show up, maybe something doesn't go as planned, but as sisters, we want to make sure that we keep our heads in all situations, that we're examples, that we are loving, that we're friendly, and that we are warm. So here are some do's and don'ts.
I have two visitors and I was just wondering if you could help me out with one of them.
No, my visitor didn't come, so I'm pretty discouraged. So I'll stay here.
Hi, good morning, Bella. Good morning. I have two visitors and I was wondering if you would help me out with one of them.
No, My visitor didn't come today, but I would love to help.
Okay, great.
Practical number 6 is be considerate. Very short and simple, we just want to consider the needs of our guests, whether they need a Kleenex, whether they need a Bible, or a better seating arrangement. We just want to make sure that our guests feel very special the day of Women's Day. So here are some do's and don'ts.
How's your guys' day?
It was good, and you know, yeah. I read like romance with my eyes.
Sorry to interrupt, but can I sit here?
No, sorry, the seat is safe.
Oh, okay, that's all right.
Yeah. How are you guys?
I'm good, how are you?
Hi, sorry to interrupt, but can I sit here?
I'm sorry, the seat is actually safe.
You can take my seat.
Oh, okay. Oh,
thank you. For sure.
Thanks so much, Bella.
Practical number 7 is be a servant. This means being aware of your surroundings. If you see a need, fill in the gap. Making sure that the visitors are also taken care of and especially that they have enough to eat. And so here are some do's and don'ts.
Wow, this looks so good. How come you didn't get any cookies?
There's no more left.
Oh. I brought you a plate of food.
Thank you so much. So nice of you.
You're welcome.
Practical number 8 is love. And the greatest act of love we can show our guests is to point them towards a relationship with God. We do not want to let Satan snatch the seed of faith that has been planted. And so I want to encourage all of the sisters to go after setting up Bible studies with all of the visitors that come out to our Women's Day. And so here are some do's and don'ts. Well, that wraps our Women's Day. Thank you so much for coming. At this time, you're dismissed.
Wow, it was so powerful today.
Yeah.
I'm so encouraged.
I'm so glad you came, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.
Okay, Nizzle.
Okay,
bye.
Well, that wraps our Women's Day today. Thank you so much for coming. At this time, you're dismissed.
Wow, that was so amazing. I'm so encouraged.
I'm so happy you came. Maybe we can meet up this week and do a Bible study or something.
Oh my gosh, I'm so down.
Yeah, are you free Thursday?
Yeah, 3.
Awesome, let's do it.
Well, there you have it, sisters. Those are all of the practicals on Women's Day etiquette. I pray you feel empowered and prepared to impact the hearts of the women that are going to come out. But I want to leave you with one last scripture in 1 Corinthians 13, verse 13. And it says, "And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love." Love you, ladies. Thank you so much for watching.